big welcome to you. Great to have you with us here at the Lauda Cross Country and Biathlon Centre. And it's biathlon that has our attention today with six exciting races on the program. A little bit chillier today up in the mountains. We've had some snow over the last couple of days, and temperature has dropped, and the snow should be just a little bit quicker. Our Japanese supporters are here looking for a big performance perhaps out of Kozokubo in our first event. It should be the men's 15K sitting. And Kozokubo is the current world champion, so they are optimistic with good cause. So six races, as I said, but two visually impaired will come later in the day. Standing categories in the middle. First up, the men's and women's 15K and 12.5K respectively. And we're just a few minutes away from the start. As has mostly been the case, they are interval starts. The athletes will go off in 30-second stages. And it is a day for gloves and hats. Some of it's been quite mild here, but today, definitely chillier. That's all right. Hasn't stopped the spectators from coming, and looking forward to a good racing today. We've got one of the athletes of the games taking part in Petushkov. We'll talk more about him in a moment. But the air temperature, just 2 degrees. Snow's still soft. Melting its way off the trees. A gorgeous shot that is. The athletes are gathering, and the first of them being called up to the start area. Aaron Pike and Travis Dodson, both from the United States, will lead us away. They're followed by Edizia of Slovakia, Rosiek, Nico, Wagner, and Halstead from the United States, Lukianenko from Belarus. Field of 22 in all. Larson, Rosiek, Flag. Good spread of nations, 11 in all. Daniel Nossen from the United States to follow Goncharov. But here we have the higher seeded athletes, and Roman Petushkov, 4 gold medals so far. He'll go out last after Kozokubo. Women's event will run alongside the men's. I'll start about 20 minutes later. Yes, that's correct. And Konovalova will be the favourite there. Just 9 in it. He's a cross between Marcel Marceau and a snowman. Yeah, he's one of Marcel the snowman, perhaps. And the Maxim Yorovyi. He will go off in the last 5. Had a pretty good games. Aleksandr Davidovich. And there's Kozokubo. He just loves being here. He's one of the happier competitors you'll see. And I love seeing him smiling. Andrew Sol, he's all business. And yet at the same time, he gives a very relaxed appearance. Very calm, and here he is, Roman Petushkov, one of the athletes of the games. He's in form, strong, fit, focused, and winning. Grigory Mirugin, just 19 years of age and from the Russian Federation. We're going to hear much more about him in years to come. I think in 4 years' time in Korea, he could well be at the top of his game. He's quick. The warmer jackets on today. There's no doubt it's cooler than it has been. I'm not sure if it's even 2 degrees. The forecast for this time of day, actually, up here at Lauda was for minus temperatures. They're telling us it's 2 degrees. Doesn't feel like it. That's all right. Once the athletes get going, they'll be nice and warm, and they're the ones that matter. And up to the line comes Aaron Pike. Aaron Pike's on his way, so that means we've got a start in the men's 15K sitting. And he's a 27-year-old from Champaign, Illinois, took part in the London Paralympic Games in track and field. He'll certainly be finding conditions different to his earlier races. Travis Dodson, US Army veteran, takes off. Competed in wheelchair racing for the University of Illinois. And for the Arizona Diamondbacks baseball team, she is going through the opening pitch on the 4th of July. There's an initiative to honor the veterans from Iraq and Afghanistan. Travis Dodson sets off around the course. 5 laps of 3 kilometers, and Vladimir Gadizia, the veteran in the field at 46 years of age, participating in his 4th Paralympic Winter Games. In cross-country, back in Salt Lake 2002, Gadizia had a silver medal finish. There's Travis Dodson making his way around that tricky little reverse camber right-hander that's just out of the stadium. Kamil Rosiek next to go. 3rd games for him. Rosiek, 29 years of age, from Novi Sad. One pike, making his way reasonably smoothly without drama around the course, and down behind the grandstand. It'll take us 11 minutes to get the field away, and then shortly after that we'll have the women's event underway. Alexander Kloniko, that's a quite measured start from him. He was 17th in the 7.5K. After Darren Pike, visibility at this stage of the day pretty good. That's a very tight left-hander, but he leans into it nicely and keeps everything upright and under control. Jeremy Wagner from Denver, Colorado, although he was born in Honolulu, and Hawaii is not a place you immediately think of as a breeding ground for winter athletes. No matter. Jeremy Wagner, here he goes. He began the sport a couple of years ago. Sean Halstead had a bit of a mixed bag of experience here. He was disqualified in the 7.5K and then 12th in the 12.5K. He'd be looking to do everything right here. Whoopsie, having said everything was under control, that's not the case for Travis Dodson. It's just a little bit of a slip. Johanny Lukyanenko had a number of top 20 finishes in Vancouver and 11th in the 7.5K here. So he's gradually improving his performances. Around 29 should be about in the peak of his athletic career. Lukyanenko on his way. Trygve Steiner Larsen. Looks like we've had a withdrawal. Another spot reserved for Romain Rosic of France. He's not out there, but Larsen is. And Larsen is a 51-year-old. There is Rosic. Looking out of order. That's all right. Pleased he's participating. I thought we were one short. We're not. Here he goes. Romain Rosic. 57-year-old from Strasbourg. Had a couple of top 20 finishes in Vancouver. In the cross-country, his biathlon results, and he had 11th, that's all right. And now we're looking at Martin Flagg. flag, was ninth in the 7.5K. And the same in the 12.5. So flag, see if he can get himself a little higher up the standings in this longer race. So this is the longest event for the men in the sitting category at 15Ks. As Aaron Pike continues to make his way around the course. You see the calculated time there. So we have a range of athletes here with impairments between the LW10 and LW12 sports classes. Mr. Loban getting ready. From Belarus. So yes, we have athletes between the LW10 and LW12 involved here, and that means we have factoring applied to their real time of between 86 and 100%. The LW12s with less impairment, 100% of their real time becomes their official time. Pike and Dodson. Pike is LW 11.5, so 97% of his time is his factored time. And that's progressive, so as they make their way around the course, you see their factored or adjusted time, calculated time, as we're showing it on the screen. All means the same thing. Ivan Goncharov. And to the last third of the field. And he gets a big cheer from the Russian fans here as he sets off. Looking at the 2.1 kilometre checkpoint. And he's just outside the quickest so far. Daniel Nossen. Sometimes skis without a hat. Not today, it's a bit too cool for that. And Daniel wisely has got the hat on. Make sure there's not too much heat lost out of the head, which I'm sure many of you know, that's the place where we do lose a lot of heat when it's cold. Had a sixth at the World Championships in the 15K, Daniel Nossen, so I do feel he'll be one to watch. It could be the longer distance will suit him. And Andrew Sol next to go. Quite a coincidence that the six American athletes go off in three groups of two back to back, so they've got each other to chase, if you like. And Sol is one of the better athletes here, that's for sure. He had a fourth in the 7.5K and fifth in the 12.5K. Can he jag a medal today? 56 there. Jeremy Wagner out on the course. Maxim Yorovy now. Yorovy, silver medalist in the 7.5K. And seventh in the 12.5K. Had a few problems at the range in that longer event. He had three penalties at the last shoot. Five laps of 3 kilometres with four visits to the range to fire off five rounds each time. Litvinenko through the 2.1K, just 1 second outside Halstead. So 5.21 through there is the quickest so far. Davidovich of the Russian Federation. Alexander's off and going. And Davidovich looking for a good result here. He's pretty handy at the cross country. Hasn't got a good result yet in the biathlon. Larson coming through. Halstead's first 2.1 Ks holding up nicely. Larson can't get inside it. This man will though, for sure. Grigori Murigan, he is quick. Got a lot of admiration for this young Russian athlete. Third last to go, so we've got most of the field out on the course. Murigan also a wheelchair athlete. Kozo Kubo. Picked up his first Paralympic medal with a third in the 7.5K, and he likes this distance. He is the current world champion over 15Ks. Rozic. Romain Rozic coming through just 5 seconds outside Halstead's time. And here he is, the Iron Man. Well, perhaps we should call him the Golden Man of biathlon and cross country. He's got two gold in each discipline so far. There's Roman Petushkov, but we're in the range now. Kornikov. First miss for him. Won't want too many. You don't want to be doing those extra loops. That's actually a minute added to your time, I think, in the longer distances. Yes, it is. So Konica, rather make them ski the extra loop, as I've been given to understand, there's a minute added to the time. The race is long enough. Wagner. Of Slovakia with the best exit time from the first bout. Out. Also one miss for Wagner. Halstead. Had a very quick time through the first checkpoint, but he's put himself back a little with that first miss. It's interesting, Gajitsia, of the first few athletes through, is the only one to shoot clear. So perhaps the colder conditions are testing the accuracy of the biathletes as they come in. Masiello. 20 seconds down almost on Tchenko from Ukraine. Kacharev, 6 seconds outside. Again, we can safely predict the race is largely going to be won and lost at the range. Nossen. So it's Tchenko who's 5 minutes 10 through 2.1 Ks is holding up pretty well. Nossen well outside it. Some 15 seconds, 12.3. It won't matter as long as the shoots straight. If someone can shoot 20 out of 20 today. Sol. This is broad-shouldered, very athletic build that Sol has and uses to great effect. He's just knocking on the door of a podium place. And maybe it'll come in this longer race. Chenko now, he's been quick around the course, steady the heart, a couple of quick breaths between shots, accurate again, just one breath this time, and again, well done, Shyshkova. Now he's put together a first 8 minutes here that give him something to work with. He's followed out by Martin Flag. Two men from different sport classes. Martin Flag 11.5 and Tchenko LW 12. Davidovich coming through. And it's Andrew Sol who's now got the best time to that first checkpoint. Any longer, as predicted, our speedy 19-year-old Murigan. Now the fastest through there. Yorogi. 18 seconds down on Murigan. Got a heavy competition schedule as Murigan, and well, more Yorogi than Murigan, but so Petushkov. That's a look. I don't know that I'd go for it, but dressing up and painting up, that's the way to go these days. That's very effective. The face painters have done a good job there. That's funny. All part of the happy atmosphere here, and I can't tell you what a great job the the presenters of the events and the Russian people and the volunteers have done, giving us a very welcome time here in Sochi, and Laura, Rosa Kuka, Gonchadov. He's done a great job hosting the games, is what I'm trying to tell you. Here we go. Yes, 5 out of 5, Gonchadov. A few more have shot clear in the back half of the field. Larson, Rozik, Flyk, Kachenko, and Loban. 65, Goncharov also joining the team. Masiello of Italy has missed a couple. Lukyanenko of Belarus has missed 3, unfortunately. Gaidizia early on also shot clear. Andrew Sol, the lefty. Got it. Andrew Sol will be just desperate to take away from what is his last event in biathlon, at least. And his best shot at a medal. He's had a fourth and a fifth, and he's just so close. Rosiek of Poland. 5.1k checkpoint. 2.5 seconds quicker than Pike. Rosiek went out fourth, closing the 54 bib. Okay, we've got Davidovic coming in, and then Murugan. Murugan's all but caught him and started 30 seconds behind him. That's a good indication of how quickly Murugan skis the course, but we'll see if he's as accurate as he is fast. Meanwhile, Davidovic. And there is Murugan. Keep an eye on both of them at once. This is good. Murugan. He's accurate and he's fast. And he's got everything at the moment. Murugan. He's away. Meanwhile, Davidovic a bit more careful and just as accurate. Oops. Yep. He's all right. Might have broken the bottom of that stock, I think. He's lost the basket off it. I don't think that's what he wants. Anyway, we saw it get a bit stuck. He may not know that he's lost the bottom of the stock. But anyway, here's Murugan. Petushkov. Now Murugan heading out. Now we've got Petushkov coming in. Eyes on the target already. Boys in this category allowed to keep stocks in their hand as that helps them get back to the upright position when they're done with the shooting. So we've had some good shooters so far. Petushkov can afford no misses, really. The pressure's been put on him. Ah, he loves the pressure. Petushkov, see you later. I'll be back in a few minutes for another go. And Petushkov just outside Murugan's time. So the Russian Federation, we've got two serious contenders here, Murugan and Petushkov. And the women's event, as we mentioned, is going to be running alongside the men's, and they're about to start with Lydia Rafaeva to lead them off. Goes up Kubo. Careful. And got this sort of twisted trunk position to stay in the chair and be able to lie down in this sort of prone position and do the shooting. Kubo makes absolutely sure of it. And he's away. There's a Kubo, LW11, so 94% backward time, but still well down on Murugan, who's really got the trip skis on today. Second shoot for Rosiek, who missed one at the first visit. Steady as she goes, Rosiek. Oh, that took a little longer, but it was worth the wait. I always think there's extra 2 or 5 seconds are well invested if it saves you a penalty. And Rosiek gets going again. Should be quicker than Pike. Women's 12.5K sitting gets underway. Oksana Abdakarimova. She's LW 10.5, so a 90% factored time for her. Dmitry Loban coming through the 5.1k checkpoint. He's well outside Tachenko's time. Tachenko's having a pretty handy race. No penalties at the first shoot. Quick around the course. Halstead of the United States. Missed one. First time round. Repositioning the elbows, looks happier with that. And Halstead shoots clear. We'll give him some encouragement as he heads off. 56 just behind him, Jeremy Wagner. So the two Americans in close quarters. 4 seconds quicker than Gaudizia, so promising middle stage of the race there for Halstead. Larson should be just be joining us for the first time to watch Paralympic biathlon. The athletes do not ski the course with the rifle on their back as the Olympians do. It's there waiting for them at the course, at the range. I mean to say, Larson continuing to shoot clear, and he makes it 10 out of 10. Two successful bouts for Larson. Out he goes, and he should be under the time of Halstead when he goes past the checkpoint. Certainly is. Now Tachenko getting himself set. Mikhailo Tachenko, Ukraine. There's a miss. Oh. Four out of five. Well, that just sets him back behind Larson now. So bad luck there for Tachenko. 8.7 seconds down. Andrea Eskow, the German, is off and away in the women's 12.5K sitting. She's had a rather curious game so far with a gold medal, two mid-race withdrawals, and then relegated from third to sixth in the sprint final. Missed a medal there after the jury looked at a four. Petushkov certainly having the challenge thrown down to him by fellow Russian Federation athlete Grigory Mirukin. Svetlana Konovalova, away she goes. Konovalova, last to go in the women's field of nine. Rafaeva was first out, and coming through the 1.6 kilometer checkpoint in 4:31.7. To the range in the men's event, and Goncharov some believe the first and fifth shots are the toughest. And he gets the lot. But Goncharov, he's 10 out of 10. Two parts to the equation, ski quickly, shoot accurately, and he's certainly got the second part under control. Nossen. Missed one at the first bout. There goes a minute. And Daniel can't afford any more misses if he's serious about a podium finish. Murigan now. Right at the top of the standings here. Oh, miss. Gets himself reset. And four out of five. That'll give Petushkov cause for hope. Not that he needs any encouragement with four gold medals. He's just oozing confidence. But a miss there from Murigan. Davidovic, shot clear, first time around. See if the targets are being knocked down and if there are any misses where they are. So if any adjustment needs to be made to the sights. They come out and zero their rifles before competition, as you may be aware. And then they hope the conditions don't change too much. But if they do, the coaches are there. Petushkov, oh, he's unbelievable. Just keeps them coming. Petushkov, he missed no targets in the 7.5K. 52 seconds ahead there, and he shot clear in the 12.5K. So that's 8 times 5. That's 40 shots without a miss for Petushkov. But it's out on the course. Dodson, 3 minutes slower than him. Back to the women's race. Andreeva making her way steadily around. There's Yarovyi, with the men and women sharing the lanes at the range. Yarovyi, no penalties, first time around. Petushkov's time is sitting there as the leading time exiting after two shoots. Yarovyi. Like Petushkin, he didn't miss in the 7.5K. Mind you, there's only 10 shots there. And there's his first miss. Spoke a bit early to help Yarovyi. Six penalties in all in the longer event, the 12.5K. So you obviously want to stop the rot right there and not have any more go wide. Larsen, 27 seconds quicker than Halstead. Larsen went out in ninth position out of the gate. And at the moment, he's leading from Halstead. Abdikarimova. Women's 12.5K. They have 5 2.5 kilometer loops to ski and 4 shoots. Abdikarimova. Just an extra moment to get set for that final shot. And again, it was time well taken. She made sure of it. And back out onto the course she goes, a minute quicker than Rafaeva. Iuliia. Got to be a medal chance here. Oh, there's a miss. Iuliia installed in third place after a controversial fall in the women's sprint. And she was fourth across the line, but given third after the jury looked at it. So that was the race that Eskow is bumped down to sixth from third. Quite a controversial little ruling there, but all squared away. Loban for Belarus, temporarily up at the top spot. Loban with no misses. Travis Dodson. Third shoot now, is deep into the race. And there's a minute penalty immediately added to the score. It's so quick. Added to the time, not the score, but just confirming for you that in this longer race, the 15K, the longest for the men, and 12.5K for the women, any shots that miss the target incur a 1 minute penalty rather than a penalty loop that has to be skied. Halstead. So one penalty so far. There's a minute thrown on. Well, that's 9 out of 10. Give him a pass for that, but I don't want to miss any more. Konovalova. My goodness, that's quick. That's as quick as Petushkov. And got some accuracy with the rifle in hand, and Konovalova on the way. Eskow missed two. Oh. He's had some health issues, Eskow. One way or another, the games have been a controversial and wildly swinging series of fortunes for her. Gold medal in the first race. Asthma attack in the second. Withdrawal in the third. And tangled up in that moment of controversy with Zainulina in the sprint. Petushkov and Murugan. Petushkov, having not missed, finds himself neatly placed here as he comes through the 8.1k, a minute and 2 seconds. But Davidovich is right behind him, and 64 is Masiello of Italy. Masiello 7 minutes down. He must have missed a few. Yes, he's got five penalties, Masiello. Loban into the range in pretty good shape, having not missed. See if the Belarusian can maintain the accuracy. What kind of a marksman is he? Two-thirds of the way through a race. Starts in the middle and will work left probably, yes. Not unusual to start in the middle and go left, and then but then to go to the far right, well, each to their own. If it works for Loban, and it clearly does, that's the way to go for him. And he's 17.7 seconds quicker than Flag, the German. So, no misses so far. A cool, calm American. Good, come on, one more. Sol gets it done, yep. Like to see accurate shooting from all of these athletes, and just seems so cool to add a minute on just for one little miss. And Sol is just so close to getting this podium finish. Will it be today? Well, if he can shoot 20 out of 20, he's a good chance. Wurdigan, meanwhile, so quick around the course. Doesn't muck around. He's 5 out of 5. Before you blinked, he's got the rounds away. He's only got one miss. And he's 13.8 seconds quicker than the American. He's all business. He's our friend Grigory Murugan. He's fun to watch. I love him. Petushkov. Mr. Perfection. Can he keep it going? It's his third biathlon event and he hasn't missed a target. He's unbelievable. Oh, I hope that's not the commentator's curse. So, Roman Petushkov, once more at the range. He's got a good lead. There'll be all focus and concentration, though. He doesn't look like he's the sort of man to take anything for granted. And five more out of five from Petushkov. Catch me if you can. He's got a minute 12 now on Murugan. Kozakubo. Couple of minutes down. Loves wheelchair marathons, does Kubo. That helps him keep fit for the cross-country and biathlon events. Rosiek coming up to the 11.1k, so we're coming towards the end of the race for some of these early starters. It's a 15-kilometre event, 5 3k laps for bouts of shooting. Andreeva Makovska, one of the early leaders in the women's event, which is now running alongside the men's. Andreeva Konovalova, a couple of the favourites in the women's. Konovalova 12 seconds quicker than Yurkovska. Russian fans could get a double result here. Rafaeva. Found the target pretty quickly with the last couple. And she's away clear after one penalty in the first visit. Lydia Rafaeva from Belarus. Getting herself settled and balanced in the chair. They taught themselves at the range to get in a shooting position with the chair still attached. Eskow, I don't think she's 100%. There's no rhythm there. There's not a lot of power. A couple of minutes down, she did miss two targets. Meanwhile, there's Travis Dodson coming through. He's 440 down. Halstead. Outside Gaudizia's time. Gaudizia, he's gone through the first three shoots clear. So is Larsen, Razik, Loban, Goncharov. Focus now though on Vainulina. He did incur a penalty at the first bout. Cheers go up from the Russian Federation with each accurate shot. And she makes it 5 out of 5, Marta Zainulina. Oh, Yurovyi. He's had a shocker here. Oh, dear. Well, this is what happened to him late in the race in the 12.5K. Yurovyi's shooting went off. That's a shame, and the look on his face is one of resignation and early defeat. He knows he can't win this race now. He's just dropped 5 minutes. 4 minutes, I beg your pardon. Now, Anya Vika. He's won the... the 10K. Oh, the 10K, Vika. Yeah, actually skied what for her was the perfect race. She couldn't believe that she didn't miss. And finished with the gold medal, and Alan was more surprised than she was. I was absolutely delighted for her. Konovalova, meanwhile, second shoot. Oh, that's preposterously quick. Konovalova. She's the quickest shooter here, men or women. Konovalova, I think she gets through those targets even quicker than Murugan. She's got be saving 5 or 10 seconds with each visit to the range, Konovalova. And she's accurate. Nordigan, meanwhile, a minute 52. Quicker than Loban. Sol just 34 seconds down on him. So Sol not far behind Nordigan. And the stands here full again. I'm just so pleased that there are good crowds here to applaud the efforts of these fine athletes. Halstead dropped the penalty at the first and third visit. This is his last shoot. Take three very quick shallow breaths between rounds. Well done, 5 out of 5 that time, so a total of 2 penalties for Halstead. 18 out of 20. Probably 7 seconds down, in front. Not for long though. There's Larson. Oh, he's a fine marksman as well. He's 15 out of 15, 20 out of 20. And Larson can go out and really attack this last 3 kilometres. 1.5 minutes faster than Halstead, so the times are coming down and down. Two more into the range. Pachenko. Started so well, penalty three, then one, then two. If that progression doesn't continue, we're going to see 3 penalties from him. We won't. And he shoots clear on the final. Well, there's no sense for that. When his body's hurting the most, he actually came up with one of his best shoots. But that's all good for him. Pachenko. Outside the time of flag though, you just can't afford multiple misses with a minute penalty for each one. Loban should go up to the far right now if he continues his pattern. He does. Brady didn't let me down there, and he hasn't let himself down. 20 out of 20 for Loban. And he's the new leader. Nordigan. Oh dear. That just makes it all that much more certain that Petushkov is closing in. And gold medal number 5. Sol, meanwhile. Can he get amongst the medals? He's certainly done his bit at the range. Now, just give this last 3 kilometres everything, and that's that look on his face of absolute determination as he goes looking for this first Paralympic medal. Oh! Too quick. Petushkov. He's got time on his side. He doesn't always need it. He's going to be extra careful here. Oh, no, he's not. He's just rattling through the targets. Oh, he's got such confidence. Petushkov sets off. Here I come. Another podium finish. I'm going to be on top of it as well. Sol in second position. Yes, we just saw the start of Sol's fall, but what's he lost there? A bit of equipment came off. Now, I hope that's not crucial for Sol's chances. Pavlenko, women's race. Ludmila Pavlenko, Konovalova, doing a good job in this one. She's shooting brilliantly today and quickly. Abdukarimova and Vika side by side. There they go. They're both 10.5 class. Rozic. He's had a good day with the rifle. Can he maintain it? There we go. Hoping that little bit of equipment that was lost by Andrew Sol was no more than a bit of sponge padding in his chair. And if it was something significant, he could be in trouble. Lazic, meanwhile. Outside Petushkov. Lysova got the penalty here in the third shoot, but just the one. And, away she goes again. One more shoot, two more laps. Gets some times up on the big screen. See how she's going. Asiello. Italian has already had six penalties, so his time has ballooned out, as you see. Yeah, put that rifle zeroed as well as he wants, or another miss. Kopska, no misses. Ukrainian trying to throw down the challenge for Konovalova. That's the way to do it. Kopska gets herself going again. Three successful shoots in the women's 12.5K. Is 105, your cluster 106. Both in the LW12 class. Halstead coming around with just 900 metres to go. 55, 10-ish. And so he's inside Cornico's time. Larson, though, quicker again. Considerably so. He's had no misses, Larson. Likewise, Loban, Goncharov, and Sol, and of course, Petushkov. Konovalova. Boom, boom, boom. Down they go again. The third shoot, and Konovalova. She's something. 28.8 seconds quicker than Yakovska, and the Russian fans here are having a fine old time watching these two biathlons unfold. Down to the finish line now comes Aaron Pike. Champaign, Illinois, originally from Park Rapids. He's left a little bit for the finish and he's driving it home nicely in just over 55 minutes. And well done to him. There's a Kubo. Fourth shoot. Japanese world champion. He make a 20 out of 20. Steady as she goes, and yes, he does. So Kubo, not quite as quick as he was that day at the Worlds, but still a very good event being strung together by him. Rosiek driving it hard down to the line. The pole well inside Pike's time. So there we've got a new benchmark, 51.39. And bit by bit, it'll get trimmed. Monaco, here we go. 2 minutes 22 inside Rosiek. Monaco, two penalties today. He's draped in snow, cloud around. But it's trying to ski himself into second position for the moment, and he's done that. He's almost 20 seconds outside Monaco's time. He's Might be the oldest man in the field, but he's one of the happier ones. The fans on their feet, trying to keep themselves warm, but jiggling up and down. It's a cold day, but it's an exciting one, especially with Russian athletes doing so well in both events. Might be Andrew Sol coming down. That's the finish. No, I'm a bit ahead of myself. This is Sean Halstead. Danico's 49-17. And Halstead will be well inside that. Halstead has had two penalties tonight. Down to the line he comes. 46 seconds quicker. Then Larson takes a fair bit off him. Larson, you can see the funny side of that, kind of. Larson's the new number one from Halstead, then Cornico. Dodson. A few too many penalties, I'm afraid, from him. He had five in all, so 5 minutes added to his time. In real time. There's Larson, a 51-year-old Norwegian. Great race. Clyde. Going to come in a little quicker than the Norwegian. Clyde with just one penalty. Such an important part of a long biathlon like this. The fatigue at the last two shoots can really mess with your shooting. Nordigen coming down. And Petushkov. Nordigen. 153.8. Quicker. Nordigen with the new fast time of 44.25.7. Here comes Loban. Outside Nordigen's time. So Nordigen is almost 2 minutes quick, 147 quicker than Loban. Flag in third position at the moment. It's Russia, Belarus, Germany. Here he comes, Andrew Sol. And he's outside Murigan's time. That little fall that cost him a few seconds. But Sol pushing it home for all that he's worth. But here's our champion, the perfect Petushkov, down in 42.20.8. Sol into third position. Petushkov, that should be 5 out of 5, and Sol maybe a bronze medal. Thank you. Wagner coming down towards the line in around 52 and a half minutes. Stylish headgear he's got on today, Wagner. I can confidently say no one's going to get near Petushkov's time. Davidovich. Oh, he's going to tip Sol out of third position, I think. Davidovich driving it to the line. Yes, he will. Davidovich. By some 6 seconds, he's beaten Sol. And Sol's fall coming out of the range a few minutes ago. Nossen into ninth. Oh, Sol. That's a heartbreaker for him. And the Americans embrace. Themselves a little tangled up there, but the camaraderie, as you'd expect, between the fellow Americans, but across nations as well. Abdikarimova, women's race, silver 9.1K. Rafaela. This is so far, fourth shoot. Getting quickly through the targets. And this. Make sure of the last. I'm smiling. Thanks good to see. He's got the right attitude. What can you do about it once it's done? Not too much. Get yourself balanced and centered. And away she goes once more for the final lap of 2.5 kilometres. Goggles in place. Vekovska, perfect shooting. Vekovska trying to take it to Konovalova. A good margin, quicker than Rafaeva through there. Rizik in the men's race coming down to the line and touch under 50 minutes. That's the kind of margin Petushkov's been enjoying over the middle of the pack, and he's too good for everybody at the moment. Good Rizik, good finish, good strong finish from him. Konovalova. How does she do it? She is so efficient, so accurate. And 36 seconds quicker than Yotkovska. And that was the last shoot for Konovalova. So out she goes once more. Everything organized here. And another Pavlenko. Two penalties so far. Clear at the last, so those two early penalties, well behind her, might have to take them back, but the second half of the race very strong on Pavlenko. Masiello comes in, bad day at the range for him. Some Germans in the crowd cheering all her successful shots, and Vicka's done it again. She shot clean, as she did in the race that she won the other day. It surprised everyone, including herself. Karimova, 1.5 centimetres in diameter are the targets, 10 metres away. Some have got this skill down pat, others struggle with it, and it costs them dearly with their overall time. There's Okubo coming down to the finish. Outside the medals today, unfortunately, for the world champion, but he's really driving it home strongly. He's got a lot of resilience, a lot of stamina. Doesn't mind a marathon distance in the wheelchair. And he always finishes strongly. Always gives us a strong performance. And a happy one. Now, Yorovyi had some big misses, unfortunately, today. At the range in one visit, so Yorovyi is across. Yes, he shot clear at the last, he missed four at the third, so five penalties in all for Yorovyi. Eskow. Two penalties in the first shoot. What it's worth, trying to read her body language. She doesn't look 100% again today, but she's battling on. 10 shoots at the second and third. There you go. So overall, 18 out of 20. It's not the energy, the vibrancy in her in the skiing. The pole's just not working that quickly through the pushes. The scout. That's right, she's a gallant competitor. One lap to go. Kotska. Up to the 11.6 kilometre checkpoint, so that leaves 900 metres to ski. Konovalova, 40 seconds, 44 seconds quicker than Yakovska. Konovalova, who finished second behind Eskow in the 6K, and second behind Vika, will feel she's due. Two silver medals so far for the woman who's leading this race. It could be a double gold day. Light snow now, as predicted. Pretty chilly up at Laura and across the way at Rosakuta. He's a little bit late, but that's all right. Good to see him here. Merry Paralympics to you. Pavlenko, a few minutes down on Konovalova's lightning quick pace today. As she comes through the 11.6K checkpoint. In a fourth spot for the moment. Here's Konovalova. Not long to go for her, and she's really going to enjoy the last few hundred metres. Konovalova, after suffering the disappointment and yet I'm sure some pride too with those two second place finishes, but to maybe get the job done here would be great for her. Andreeva has not shot well today. Let's drag her time down. Andreeva has, she's missed seven targets in all. 7 minutes added to her time, Andreeva. So she missed one, then three, then two, then one. And women just starting to come across the line now, won't be long before we've got a finish to their race as well, and it should be Konovalova, but meanwhile in comes Yakovska. Yakovska, who was a third in the 6K and fourth in the 10K, and Yakovska coming down 41.30, it'll be about for Olena Yakovska of Ukraine, 41.30.8. Zainulina, second for the moment, but Zainulina, and she only had the one miss. Yakovska had none, so Yakovska shot clear. And Lydia Rafaeva across the line, 5.50 behind. She missed three targets today. And here is Svetlana Konovalova. Two second place finishes. I think she's going to go one better here. The crowd roaring her home. Svetlana Konovalova across the line in 40-44. And that should secure her a gold medal. gets the congratulations of Yakovska, as he's absolutely delighted. 2 seconds, beaten by Eskow and then Vicker, and now she's going to be triumphant. So they're coming through now. This is Ludmila Pavlenko. Pavlenko missed the 2 targets today. A couple of minutes added to her time. And Pavlenko took out of the medals today. And just will certainly come in a clear fourth. And just the finishing straight to complete. Pavlenko had a 7th in the 6K. And a 3rd. In the 10K, so she will be leaving the game with at least 1 medal. Pavlenko across in 4th. There's that Andreeva and Anya Vika side by side. Make sure they don't swing each other down here as they carefully negotiate this long right-hand turn. Anya Vicker. She sights on another medal here. She was the surprise welcome winner of the 10K. Andreeva and Vicker. Vicker, or can she get there in time to maybe claim the silver medal? Vicker. He's got 10 seconds to get there to beat Yakovska's 41.30. Vicker driving it, pushing it. Will she get there? I think she will. Vicker across the line with a couple of seconds to spare into second place. And Anya Vicker shoots clear again. Gets another incredibly surprising result. But that's what you can do if you don't miss. And Andreeva across the line also. Out of the medals today, she missed a swag of targets, but Anya Vicker, 2 incredible performances from her. 6th place in the first event, the 6K, then she's won the 10K, and she could get second here, almost assuredly so, with just a couple to finish. Abdekarimova and Eskow. Can't see Eskow, and I'm starting to think that she may have withdrawn. Can't be sure, but Abdekarimova coming around. I don't have a withdrawal yet from Eskow, but and I hope she's able to complete the race. She certainly didn't look at her best. Abdekarimova pushing it down to the line. Maybe not quite quick enough to squeeze into 4th position. And she won't be, but it's been a good race from her. Abdekarimova has shot 20 out of 20. That's outstanding. And she's going to have a good finish here. She comes in 5th, 2 minutes 29 behind Konovalova. Another exciting race for the women, and Konovalova getting that lucid gold medal after a couple of silvers. Vicker, strong finish, great shooting. In fact, our top three, Konovalova, Vicker and Yakovska, all 20 out of 20. With a rifle in hand. Abdekarimova also shot clear. And here she is, Andreeva Eskow. She's clearly not at her fittest. And she's battling on. Almost looked uncertain about where she had to ski there. I don't think that everything's working as it should. She's a fighter. She's a London Paralympic double gold medalist in hand cycling. And she's certainly got her supporters, and she'll be delighted for the success of Anya Vicker. In fact, both of them are going to leave town with a gold medal. Eskow won the 6K, Vicker the 10K. Out today has missed two targets, you see. She should have finished some time ago, but she's clearly not feeling too well. She's managing a smile. Oh, that's encouraging. That's great to see. Look up and see the flag of your nation being waved. That's a lifter as Eskow pushes it down to the line. We've had all sorts of fortune and misfortune at these games. But, she'll take some pride out of finishing this race. And Eskow across in 46.19.1. And the seventh spot for her. That's the field finished. Takes the little transponders off to allow us to detect them out on the various checkpoints. Results for the men. There is Roman Petushkov. Five events, five gold medals. Murigan in second, Davidovich third, and the slightly unlucky Andrew Sol in fourth. Then Goncharov, Kubo, Loban, and Flag. A lot of men shot clear there. Great to marksmanship. Larson also. Nossen and Halstead at the US. Ukraine pair, Yorovy and Koniko in 12 and 13. Muzik, Chechenko, Gaiditsia in Slovakia in 16th. And Rosiek, Wagner, Pike, Masiello, Dodson. Lukianenko not able to finish today. Roman Petushkov. What's that at the moment? Results for the women's 12.5K. Svetlana Konovalova. Anya Vika, Elena Yakovska, 1-2-3. They didn't miss a target between them. Zainulina was fourth and Abdakarimova fifth. Oksana Abdakarimova also. Two races run and won. Both of them excellent results for the host nation, and this crowd certainly waiting on to see the flower presentations. They will come along shortly, and I invite you to stay with us to watch the joy and fun of those. That's a nice hat. Something slightly traditional about that. Yes, the presentation's just a little time off, a minute or three. So do stand by, and we'll look forward to those and hope you can stay with us.
Спортсменов России!
Wow, ceremony for the men's 15K sitting. Grigory Mirikin making his way out. It's a Russia 1-2-3. Petushkov, Murigan and Davidovich. I shouldn't be too surprised they were seeded as three of the last four to go. Tozo Kubo of Japan, as the current world champion, was second last to go, but his pace around the course not quite up to those of the others, even if his shooting was. So Davidovich, Murigan and Petushkov it is, and Petushkov is emerging as perhaps the athlete of the games. Five wins from five starts.
Representing Russian Federation.
Бронзовый призер, представитель Российской Федерации, Александр Давидович.
And for Davidovich, it is his first Paralympic medal. Prior to this, he had a sixth in cross country in Vancouver and Torino.
Thank you.
It is his third Paralympic Games. Nine-year-old from Ufa. It really means a lot to him. World Championships, he's had a couple of bronze medals, but that was a few years ago in Finland in
2009. Russian Federation.
Grigory Murigan. The 19-year-old from Omsk, world champion in relay, second in the 10K and third in the 1K. That's at the World Championships last year in cross country, and a first in the 7.5K in the biathlon. So his World Championship results recently suggesting he would do something special here, and so it's proving as he picks up second in the men's 15K.
Gold medalist. Paralympic champion representing Russian Federation.
Золотую медаль и звание чемпиона паралимпийских игр завоевал представитель Российской Федерации Роман Петушков.
Roman Petushkov. Well, this is a now familiar scene as the 36-year-old from Moscow takes top spot on the podium. He's won all three sitting biathlon events now. And it's his fifth gold medal overall. And he's not finished yet. So Roman Petushkov, Grigory Mirugin and Alexander Davidovich, all from the Russian Federation. 1-2-3 in the men's 15K sitting.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, the flower ceremony for the biathlon women's 12.5 kilometer sitting.
Дамы и господа, цветочная церемония награждения победителей и призеров по биатлону. 12,5 километров женщины в классе Сидя.
Well, there's lots to like about this race. The victory from Svetlana Konovalova after a couple of silver medal finishes for her. A supreme performance again from Anya Vicka, who's backed up gold in the 10K with silver here. And Yakovska is now one of the most decorated Paralympic skiers. He's got 17th podium finish now in cross country and biathlon.
Господин Иван Пиронко, заместитель губернатора Краснодарского края.
Bronze medalist representing Ukraine.
Бронзовый призер, представительница Украины.
Olena Yurkovska from Kiev. Coming into these games, she'd won 15 Paralympic medals, all colours. Going back to Salt Lake when she first won three bronze medals in cross country. And a silver in the 7.5K biathlon.
Germany!
Серебряный призер, представительница Германии!
Anya Vicker's personal motto is no risk, no fun. And she has plenty of fun out there, and I'm pleased to see her on the podium again. Did pick up a silver medal in the 6K at the World Championships last year, so there was an indication that maybe she had a podium finish in her. Well, she's had two now. She's won the 10K and second in the 12.5.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Russian Federation.
Золотую медаль и звание чемпионки Паралимпийских игр завоевала представительница Российской Федерации Светлана Коновалова.
Светлана Коновалова up to the top of the podium after finishing second in both the 6K and 10K, behind firstly Andrea Eskow and then Anya Vicker. So finally, after knocking on the door twice, it's opened for her. And the story of how she was raised in a children's home, and just last year she learnt she had a sister, Yevgenia. The pair has met up. Yevgenia is a volunteer here at these Paralympic Winter Games in Sochi. Family reunion, and I'm sure Yevgenia is immensely proud of what Svetlana has done here. Svetlana Konovalova, Anya Vicker, Olena Yakovska, a place getters in the women's 12.5K sitting biathlon. Well, two races have been completed. There's another four on the program today, which will complete the schedule for the biathlon. I hope you'll be able to enjoy those with us. Just taking a short break now, though, from Laura, and I hope you can join us again. For the moment, it's goodbye.